So NetFlow traffic is by design not a small data set. And understanding exactly what you want will help you understand how you're best using your interfaces and applications. So let's go ahead and do two examples. We're going to start with what kind of application traffic is moving around my environment. We're going to start at the Orion summary screen. We'll go to My Dashboards, NetFlow, and the NTA summary. So let's take the example that I want to know how much monitoring traffic, specifically SNMP, is going in and out of my West data center, or more specifically, just out of my West data center. So we'll go to the NetFlow Navigator. We'll change to a detail type. We'll select NBAR2 application. We select our West data center. And we'll select our MPLS circuits, not our internet circuit, since our monitoring is internal. Then we need to select the type of application, in this case, SNMP. And there it is. For me, I care about, let's go for one day. The direction will go with egress only. And in my environment, I use IPv6 for something very specific, so I only need to see IPv4 traffic. And that's it. We'll submit. So you can see we just built this view, NetFlow NBAR2 summary in SNMP for the last one day, egress for your direction, IPv4, traversing through this router using this interface. So this is a great way to understand what kind of SNMP traffic is leaving or entering one of your data centers. If you find this view useful, you can always save it. So expand the Flow Navigator out again. It maintained all of your settings. And save filter view to the menu bar. And let's call it SNMP West. There we go, it's been saved. So now, from anywhere in the product, it'll be Home, NetFlow, SNMP West. The other question that comes up with NetFlow a lot is what's actually going through my interfaces, especially if you pay for expensive MPLS or PRI type circuits. You want to know what's actually traversing those links. So let me show you how to do that. Again, we'll start from the summary page. So NetFlow summary. This is going to be a more general filter. So let's go to Flow Navigator. Let's look at a detail on the interface. And we'll select my East WAN circuit. And let's go ahead and check our internet circuit, see what's going out over the web. And submit. So this one, because I didn't change the time period, stuck at 1 hour, is looking at both directions and is looking at IPv4 and v6, but it's a NetFlow interface details through the East WAN router through the internet circuit. And here you can see most of the traffic going out is HTTPS or port 443, so secure HTTP. Second to that is HTTP, and then so on and so forth. Again, if you want to save this, return to the Flow Navigator, and save filter view to menu bar. The NetFlow Navigator lets you filter your data in any number of ways. You can use IP groups, you can use protocol groups, you can build your own custom applications inside of it so it knows that these TCP and UDP ports actually belong to this type of homegrown application. And these are just some of the ways that NetFlow Navigator can help you out. For more information, visit SolarWinds.com.